Hello dear students, hope you are all doing great in your life. In the last previous sessions, we discussed about what is the life process and different topics about the life process. Till we discussed the nutrition, today we will discuss the respiration topic from your NCERT books. We can also see in last sessions are how food digest in our body, how they can absorb in our bloodstream. And today we will discuss after the process of the absorption of food, how they make energy with the help of oxygen, that is called aerobic respiration. So basically respiration are of two types, that is called external respiration and internal respiration. Okay, external respiration and internal respiration. Basically, external respiration, when we talk about external respiration, that means it is done by with the help of outer nostril. Okay, there is the lungs. Okay, one left side lung is slightly tilted and right side lung is like this. Okay, there is the presence of heart. Okay, so their external respiration means through the nostril, when we take air through the nostril and passes to the lungs with the help of this trachea. This is called trachea. Okay, this is the lungs. There is left lung, right lung, the branching of their lung, that is called bronchia and bronchiole. And what is the functional unit of lung? That is called alveoli. It is called alveoli. This is the small balloon like structure. This is called alveoli. Okay, this is called alveoli. Alveoli is the functional unit of, or a structural and functional unit of lungs. So basically when air passes through this nostril, this go into the lungs with the help of this trachea, and branches of their lungs is called bronchial, then alveoli. In alveoli, the filtration of blood is also happen, and in the basal of alveoli, there is the passage of veins basically. Veins is called pulmonary artery here, not veins, pulmonary artery, which located besides the alveoli. And in pulmonary artery there is deoxygenated blood, but after the exchange of gases, which gas? Oxygen gas. Alveoli, from alveoli to this pulmonary artery, this is pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery located besides the alveoli, and when a gas exchange takes place from the alveoli to pulmonary artery basically deoxygenated blood, and after the exchange of oxygen to the pulmonary artery, it becomes oxygenated and passes to the heart, and the heart pumps throughout the body. Okay, so there is the actual site of exchange of air, and when oxygen released to the bloodstream and carbon dioxide released to the alveoli, and when we breathe out, when we exhale breathing, that means this carbon dioxide comes out of the body, and this process takes automatically process, that is called breathing. Okay, when we breathe in, breathe out, exchange of gases, he goes and out. Okay, why exchange of oxygen takes place here, and why carbon dioxide goes out, why oxygen goes in? Because of the pressure. Okay, environmental pressure. if this there is the two condition, this is called thoracic area, this is called thoracic, that is called thoracic pressure. When we talk about thoracic pressure, when we breathe in or breathe out in environmental, that is called environmental pressure. Environmental pressure in environment, there is 21% of oxygen present and only 0.03% of CO2 carbon dioxide takes place, carbon dioxide place. Okay, so in external environment, the concentration of, or we can say the pressure of oxygen is high, and in thoracic pressure of oxygen is low. That's why its movement of oxygen from higher to lower, means from external environment to thoracic area. Okay, that means external pressure is high and thoracic area oxygen, in thoracic pressure of oxygen is low, that means flow of oxygen from high to low. In the case of CO2, okay, there is the very low concentration in environment. That means the environmental pressure of CO2 in environment is low, and in thoracic area pressure of CO2 is high. Okay, there is the pressure of O2 and pressure of O2, okay, low, which is low in thoracic. The pressure of CO2 is low in environmental environment, and in thoracic area or thoracic pressure of CO2 is high. That means flow of CO2 from high to low. That's why when we breathe out, carbon dioxide comes out of our body, and when we breathe in, oxygen takes place into the bloodstream in our body. Okay, just because of environmental or thoracic pressure, the movement of oxygen and carbon dioxide takes place. Okay, so the exchange of air through the external environment, that is called external respiration, and the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the cellular, at the cellular level in bloodstream, that is called internal environment, internal respiration. This is also called cellular respiration. Cellular respiration, because this exchange of air takes place at cellular level. Okay, after oxygen goes into the bloodstream, this is bloodstream. Oxygen dissolve it in it. How this oxygen use it? How this bloodstream use this oxygen? Okay, so we will see here. When we take food, in a digestion topic, we will study that when we take food, it digested in the form of small particles like glucose, protein, and absorb into the bloodstream. So in this bloodstream, glucose molecule also present, okay, and the cell, the cytoplasma of the cell, there is the cell, particular cells in all our body, the cells are present, and in the cells, glucose transported by the blood and oxygen also transported by the blood, and suppose in the upper layer of these cells wants to divide. How can divide? By the using of nutrition and food, they will make divide. So how they can use oxygen and this food material for the use of, for the growth and division. Okay, so there is the cell, this is nucleus, and this is the cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, glucose molecule are present, and glucose converted into 2-pyruvate molecule. Glucose is 6-carbon molecule, and pyruvate basically is 3-carbon molecule, just because 6 breaks into the 2 carbonic compound, that is called pyruvate. Okay, when this pyruvate have supply of sufficient oxygen, okay, I make this here, glucose gives 2-pyruvate. Okay, there is the fate of the pyruvate. There is the 3 way of the digestion of pyruvate or formation of energy through pyruvate, that is called, when supply of oxygen is sufficient, that is called aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration, that means oxygen are present, that when oxygen are present, it pyruvate gives 32 ATP molecule. What is ATP? ATP is the currency of energy in our body. And what is the full form of ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. This is the currency of energy in our body. Okay. Then 32 ATP will formed by this pyruvate molecule. Okay. This is called aerobic respiration, and it takes place in mitochondria. Mitochondria. Okay. When there is a lack of oxygen, that means oxygen are present, but concentration is lack. This is called lack of oxygen. Okay. This is the lack of oxygen takes place in muscle, or when we does heavy work. Okay. There is, that means when we, why we after the so much running or after the so much doing work, why we take higher breathing, number of rates are very high, just because supply of oxygen required in very high concentration. So our lungs continuous work and pump the oxygen to the cells for the supply of this oxygen. In that condition, there is the also some oxygen concentration not sufficient for that particular muscle. When we do very high amount of gym, this muscles start paining. Okay, our thighs start paining. Why? Because in that area there is not sufficient oxygen supplied. Okay, so there is if lack of oxygen in a muscular cells, it will form lactic acid plus some energy. Okay, plus some energy, not sufficient energy, because sufficient energy was 32 ATP molecule. Okay, this is called lactic acid. Okay, lactic acid is the acid when it form in our muscles, it will start pain basically, it will pain to our muscles. The third condition is called absence of oxygen. There is no oxygen. Absence of oxygen, that is called anaerobic respiration. Okay, and it will takes place in yeast. Okay, when we talk about yeast fermentation, it will also called fermentation reaction means absence of oxygen, the reaction takes place, that is called fermentation reaction. Okay, and in yeast it will form ethanol. Okay, ethanol plus 2 ATP molecule, this is called anaerobic reaction. And what is this ethanol? What is the example of ethanol? CH3CH2OH, this is ethanol. Basically it is an alcoholic compound. Okay, alcoholic compound. So when making a beer, wine, when making a beverages, the use of fermentation reaction takes place with the help of yeast. Okay, that's why we can convert them into the ethanol. Is it clear? There is the three fate of pyruvate through which it can convert it in different parts, like lactic acid, ethanol, or 32 ATP molecule in mitochondria. The best respiration is aerobic respiration, which takes place in the presence of oxygen, and this oxygen comes to when we take breathe in and when availability of oxygen in our body. Okay, if there is the lack of oxygen, that means lactic acid formed and not adequate amount of energy will form. Okay, and when we lactic acid form, that means paining of the muscle. Third condition was anaerobic reaction, that means absence of oxygen, totally absence of oxygen. It will also called fermentation reaction, and it will takes place with the help of yeast fermentation, that is called yeast fermentation. And what is the product of this reaction? Ethanol and 2 ATP molecule. And what is this ethanol? It is an alcoholic compound which formed due to the absence of oxygen, that is called anaerobic respiration. Okay, so this is all about respiration. And respiration are of two types, external and internal. I hope you all understand this. Okay. This is all about respiration. So just learn all these topics and what is your query, what is your doubts, also send me or also give me some feedbacks. Okay, so all the best. Learn till the respiration. In the next session we will discuss about transportation and excretion process. So all the best. Do your study.